Hey, what's going on, fam? Welcome to Road to Recovery episode 6. Now in this video, we're gonna be diving into my lower body workout. Now thankfully, I'm able to start squatting again and I'm doing different movements that actually the doctors told me I would never be able to do again, and I'm super excited. Now I do have a little cold, I've been traveling a lot, and I'm actually here in Tampa, Florida at the Powerhouse gym. So we're gonna jump into it in just a second, but first I wanna tell you a few different things. You know, number one, if you are someone who's trying to work out and you've been approached with some type of setback, whether that is an injury or you don't have the money to go to a gym or whatever it is, you can find a way to get through those issues by thinking and just taking a few steps back. And that's really where I had to make adjustments. I had to take a couple steps back and understand my situation in order to keep progressing and move forward. I knew that I could not do crazy muscle-ups yet, but as I keep on progressing through my rehabilitation and everything that I'm doing, I know that I'll get there if I'm patient and I just make sure that I'm seeing everything from a 50-yard view. So that's number one. Number two, if you are training any type of way, don't go too hard. Think very logically. Do not think of anything that's going to hurt you. Don't do any type of movements that are absolutely crazy or anything like that. Be very specific, but keep that proper technique and don't run into any issues because you're trying to just be the biggest man or the girl in the gym, lifting the most weight or trying to get the most shredded. Don't put your health at risk because you're trying to be just a badass, all right? So with that being said, let's just jump into this workout. Enjoy, let's have some fun. Consistency and too much consistency actually breeds injury. And so when we're training, you know, we can do 6 reps, right? And we'll do that 3 sets. And then the next time we train, we'll do 3 sets of 6 reps, right? And we'll do it the next day and the next day and the next day. And actually, sometimes what we'll do is we'll do it every single day because we feel like, oh, we're not sore. Hey, I'm just grinding, I'm just hustling. And the problem with that is that all you're doing is tearing down your muscles to a point where it has no time to recover. It has no time to get any stronger. And so what you're actually doing is just injuring yourself. You're putting yourself in a situation, I'm gonna go down in here into reverse bear crawls, but you're putting yourself in a situation where you're not going to see the growth that you want. And then you wonder, well, why am I not seeing the best results? So I know that was a little dumb example of the 3 sets of 6 reps every single day. But the problem is that that's what we do. We train every single day and we don't even realize that we're not allowing our body to rest. Same thing goes with business. Same thing goes with every single thing that you do. You know why I'm injured? Because I didn't listen to my own advice. Because I said, hey, I need to make these videos. I need to train. I need to get stronger. I need to grow my business. I need to provide for my family. I try to do every single thing in the world. In reality, all I was doing was putting myself in an even horrible situation, and now I have a body that's injured. So, road to recovery is going great. Shoulders bothering me a little bit today, but back is amazing, and we're getting ready to smash and continue this workout. So what I'm gonna be doing here, as you guys know, my low spine, I gotta be very controlled with every single movement that I do, right? So I'm working on core stability, overall stability around my spine, so your rectus spinae. Oh, so you have muscles, 3 muscles that run down the spine, okay? You also have your QLs, which are down here near your hips, right? So what I'm gonna be doing is time under tension. Now, if you don't know what time under tension is, and I'm gonna demonstrate it as I'm going through, I'm keeping everything retract, right, and depressed. So I'm staying in a tight position, so my spine is in a neutral position. My chin isn't flexed too much. It's right in that neutral position here, okay? And as I come up, I'm going very, very slow. So time under tension is anything from 2 to 10 seconds through a movement, and you wanna do anywhere from 1 to 6 repetitions. Now essentially, I'm not gonna go into the science behind it, but it's gonna be working your muscles in a different way. But as your muscles are activated, you have to really tighten up through that core, right? So anterior and posterior core. As you're going down, move very, very slow. Usually with this movement, trap bar deadlifts, I'm gonna be going for about, I would say, 6 to 8 seconds on the way up, squeezing my hips through here, and I'm gonna be coming through down as so. And once you complete that, I'm telling you, it'll burn. You're gonna feel it in a completely different way. So I just finished off with 80 yard sled pushes with 45 pounds on the sled push. So Estee's gonna demonstrate, because I didn't have anybody there filming for me. I almost threw up after the second one. I'm gonna show you right now what Estee's doing. So rather than, yeah, so you wanna be here, yeah, a little bit lower, right there. Bring that butt down a little bit. Tuck in that stomach though. There you go. So as you can see, he's bringing his knees up higher. He's going all the way down and then all the way back. So that was our conditioning for today. There you go, you're good. You're good. So thanks for tuning in for Road to Recovery. Back is feeling freaking amazing. I gotta admit, but my shoulder, to be honest, is really giving me a tough time today and yesterday for some reason. But all in all, great session. Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe if you haven't already. Give it a thumbs up. Comment down below. I'll see you next time. Peace.